हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम किरणदीप गर्ग फ्रॉम यूजम शिक्षा केंद्र। टुडे वी डिस्कस द बेसिकली सिक्स्थ पार्ट ऑफ आवर एमसीक्यू सीरीज। इन दिस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम 86 टू 100 एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द एमसीक्यूज मेनली फ्रॉम चैप्टर 3 एंड वेरी फ्यू क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम चैप्टर 4। नियर अबाउट 10 क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम चैप्टर 3 एंड नियर अबाउट 4 टू 5 क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम चैप्टर 4। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। आई एम किरणदीप गर्ग फ्रॉम यूजम शिक्षा केंद्र। इफ यू लाइक अवर वीडियो प्लीज प्रेस द लाइक बटन एंड सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल। वी कॉन्टिन्यूसली अपलोड लेक्चर्स ऑन अल्टरनेट डेज ऑफ प्रिंसिपल्स एंड प्रैक्टिसेस ऑफ बैंकिंग एंड लीगल ऑफ बोथ थ्योरी एंड MCQs, and also share with your friends. Also, our Facebook page is Aim to Achieve, and all our lecture updates are in our Telegram group, Jab UJAM. And for more proper information, please refer our handwritten notes. For our handwritten notes, you have to mail on our email ID ujam2493@gmail.com. All notes are handwritten notes and updated with the respect to the present paper level. So let's start with the question discussion. Question number 86. Which of the following does not match? Basically, we have given three statements and we have to find that which of the following does not match. So statement one is, there is no restriction on allowing loans and advances against its share by a bank. Basically, it says that there is no restriction on allowing loans and advances against its shares by bank, and this is false one. So this is our correct one, because there is some restriction, and as per statement is there is no restriction, so this is false. So this is correct one, because this statement is false. Second one, a bank can lend to a firm in which its director is a partner. No, bank cannot lend to its firm in which its director is a partner. So no, so false. This is also correct one. And we have to find that which does not match or which does not correct. Bank cannot grant loans to firm in which their directors are grantors. So this is true one. This is right. So this is our answer. Bank cannot grant loans to firm in which their directors are grantors. True. This is to be false. Bank cannot grant loans to firm in which their directors are grantors. Here we have given true, but this is the false statement. So our answer is option number C. Question number 87. In the context of selective credit control, this is the policy. Basically, under chapter 3, we have discussed this one. Which of the following is correct? For these types of question, you have to follow our notes or properly theory. RBI can specify the purpose for which advances may or may not be granted. Which of the following is correct? So this is the correct one. RBI can specify the purposes for which advances may or may not be granted. This is the correct one. So we have to check further options also, but this is our answer, because this statement is it is correct one. RBI can give directions to banks in general and not to a particular bank. No, this is not a correct one. RBI can give directions in general also or to a particular bank also. Both are the possibilities. RBI can give the direction in the interest of banking policy, not for other matter. RBI can give the direction in the interest of banking policy and for public interest. So both are needed to be mentioned here. So this is also false one. So our answer is option number A. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज इन केस ऑफ नॉमिनेशन फॉर डिपॉजिट अकाउंट्स द नॉमिनी कैन ऑब्टेन द पेमेंट ऑफ डिपॉजिट. व्हेन कैन नॉमिनी ऑब्टेन द पेमेंट ऑफ डिपॉजिट. बेसिकली नॉमिनेशन द रोल ऑफ नॉमिनेशन कम्स आउट व्हेन द ओरिजिनल और अकाउंट होल्डर इज डेड. सो बिफोर मैच्योरिटी इन केस ऑफ टर्म डिपॉजिट. इन द केस ऑफ टर्म डिपॉजिट द नॉमिनेशन नॉमिनी कैन गेट द पेमेंट ऑफ डिपॉजिट ओनली इन द केस ऑफ टर्म डिपॉजिट बिफोर मैच्योरिटी. सो दिस वन इज करेक्ट वन. सो दिस इज अवर आंसर बिकॉज फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट इज करेक्ट एंड ऑल द क्वेश्चन आर ऑफ सिंगल चॉइस. बट वी हैव टू चेक अदर ऑप्शन ऑल्सो फॉर मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन. ड्यूरिंग द लाइफ टाइम ऑफ डिपॉजिटर नो. इवन वैन देर इज डायरेक्शन फ्रॉम कोर्ट टू द कॉन्ट्रेरी. बेसिकली द नॉमिनी कैन गेट पेमेंट इन केस ऑफ एनी कोर्ट डिसीजन नॉट टू द कॉन्ट्रेरी. अदर वन गिव डिस्चार्ज ऑन एफ डी आर फॉर रेजिंग अ लोन आफ्टर डेथ ऑफ द अकाउंट होल्डर. गिव नो डिस्चार्ज. देर इज नो नीड ऑफ डिस्चार्ज ऑन एफ डी आर फॉर रेजिंग अ लोन आफ्टर डेथ ऑफ द अकाउंट होल्डर. फॉर बेसिकली दीज ऑल आर कंडीशन फॉर द नॉमिनी. सो हेयर इफ दे गिव नो डिस्चार्ज देन दिस इज करेक्ट वन. बट देर इज नो वर्ड रिगार्डिंग नो इज गिवन सो दिस इज द फॉल्स स्टेटमेंट. सो आंसर इज ऑप्शन नंबर ए. After that question number 89. When articles lying in safe custody of the bank, basically when articles lying in the safe custody of the bank are handed over to the nominee after death of the account holder. Basically under which section articles are lying in the safe custody? Under section 45ZC. Custody C. ZC, same CC, basically under section 45ZC of the BR Act. So when articles lying in safe custody of the bank are handed over to the nominee after death of the account holder, then the bank gets valid discharge. Yes, the bank gets valid discharge. This is our answer. Because when the death of the account holder is happen, then the all things are to be given to the nominee as per prescribed in the nomination form. So the bank gets valid discharge. Other option is the bank gets valid discharge only if it is with the consent of the legal heirs. There is no role of the legal heirs when nominee is mentioned. If this is not mentioned, then the amount is to be dealt basically goes with the legal heirs. But when the nomination is mentioned, then there is no other person comes. The bank gets valid discharge when no dispute is raised by the legal heirs. No, this is also false one. The bank gets valid discharge only if there is a court direction. This is also not happen. The bank gets valid discharge when the nomination is written on the nomination form and when the bank gives or handed all articles in the safe custody to the nominee. Question number 90. This question is little bit tricky one. Which of the following provision does not match in the context of nomination? For deposit accounts, nomination is basically under section 45ZA. The account holder nominate only one person. And under which section? Section 45ZA of the Banking Regulation Act. So this is true one. Does not match. We have to find that which of the following. For safe custody of articles, accounts, basically custody ZC, this is ZE. This is not true. This is false one. For safe deposit vault lockers accounts under section ZC. For safe deposit vault locker section is section 45ZE of the Banking Regulation Act. This is also false one. Which of the following provision does not match? So both B and C. This is to be both b and c does not match. So here correct option is not given, so we manipulate the option d, which is to both b and c does not match. So question number 91, which of the following tools are not used by RBI under selective credit control directives? Basically selective credit control directive, which of the following tools are not used? Minimum margin for lending, this is to be used, this is also used. Ceiling on the level of circuit, ceiling is also, because RBI can fix particular amount, so basically this is known as ceiling. Minimum rate of interest on advances to select commodities, basically to select commodities, basically specific commodities, interest rate is minimum on advances. When we bank gives a loan, the interest rate is minimum. So all these three are basically used by RBI to under selective credit control directive. So here option is D, none of the above. This is our answer, because above all are used by the RBI, and here in the question we have asked which of the following tool are not used. So answer is none of the above. Then question number 92, most important question, because question basically little slightly typical. Section 20A, here we have give in the notebook or in our notes we have specifically mentioned section 20 and section 20A. So first of all, you have to understand section 20 of the Banking Regulation Act. Basically section 20 of the Banking Regulation Act imposes certain restriction on loans and advances. Basically section 20 imposes some restriction on loans and advances. However, section 20A of same Banking Regulation Act, basically restriction on power to remit debit to its directors requires prior permission of RBI under section 20A. Basically when banks gives loans or give remittance to their directors, they need prior permission from RBI under section 20A of the RBI Act. So answer is option number B, because banks can write off the loans in the name of directors with the prior permission of RBI. So this is our answer. So like option A, bank cannot grant loans on the security, this is not regarding 20A, this is also not regarding 20A. Banks cannot lend on, basically we have to remember the section. Basically what this section says, if we remind the section, then we can easily tackle with the question. Next question number 93, which of the following rates of interest on advances are fixed by banks themselves? Like ceiling rate on loans to exporters, this is fixed by RBI and we have to find by the banks. Loans under DRI, basically DRI, differential rate of interest, this is less rate of interest basically for weaker sections of society. So this is also fixed by RBI. Benchmark prime lending rate, BPLR, this is fixed by the bank itself, and we have to find that which of the following rate of interest on advances are fixed by the bank itself. So this is our answer, answer option number C. So ceiling rate on loans up to rupees 2 lakh in priority sector, this is also fixed by RBI. So this is our answer option number C, BPLR is fixed by the banks itself. So question number 94, under section 25(1) of the Banking Regulation Act, bank submits to RBI a return relating to, basically under section 25(1) they have to submit a return regarding assets, and basically assets maintained in India, you have to remember that, assets maintained in India within 1 month from end of every quarter. Basically under section 25 we have to dealing regarding quarter, and under section 24 we have to regarding after every month. So here section 25, so this is quarter, here in 24 this is to be month. We'll discuss in some other question this point. So under section 25(1) of the Banking Regulation Act, banks have to submit to RBI return relating to assets maintained in India within 1 month from end of every quarter. So this is our answer. So question number 95, same with respect to the section 25(1). If the last Friday is a holiday, the return under section 25(1) of the Banking Regulation Act can be submitted to RBI relating to, basically if the last Friday is a holiday, then it is submitted to be on the previous working day. So this is next, no, previous day either it is to be Sunday or not Sunday but Thursday. If Thursday is on a holiday, then this is not possible. So next working day, not one preceding working day, basically previous working day. So this is our answer. Next, RBI can carry inspection of banks by exercising powers under, basically RBI can carry inspection under section 35 of the Banking Regulation Act. So this is the answer option B, under section 35 of the Banking Regulation Act, RBI can carry inspection of banks. Then question number 97, if a bank makes appropriation from reserve fund, so what is the meaning of here appropriation? In the video lecture I also discussed specifically what is the meaning of appropriation. Basically take some money legally from the fund, basically this is the meaning, take some money or money set aside by the formal action, take some money by the formal action. So this is the meaning of appropriation from the reserve fund. If a banks make appropriation from the reserve fund created under section 17(1) of the Banking Regulation Act, it has to be report the matter to RBI. Basically this is to be report the matter to RBI within 21 days of such appropriation. So this is our answer. Under how many days? Within 21 days from such appropriation, the matter is to be reported to the RBI. So next one is, while taking a decision on the complaint filed by a customer, the ombudsman, basically when there is complaint filed by a customer, then there is decision, the ombudsman follow the general guidelines issued by the government, SEBI or RBI. Second one is, the ombudsman takes into account the circumstances and frames its own rules. This is not one, as there is no provision regarding frame its own rules. Takes into account RBI directive. So this is a correct one. Among three options, C is the most appropriate or the correct one with respect to the decision. Basically the ombudsman takes into account the RBI directives. So this is our answer. Next one is, the banking companies are required to prepare profit and loss account, basically PL account, and balance sheet. Basically banking companies are required to make or prepare profit and loss account and balance sheet as at close of the financial year. Basically this is to be prepared at the close of the financial year. Earlier the financial year is closed on December 31, but in 1992 it is to be made March 31. This is the power of the central government. Basically central government can change this financial year. So presently financial year is from 1st of April to 31st of March. So answer is option number B. And this is the last question of the today's lecture. Who has the powers to change the day for the purpose of preparation of profit and loss account in balance sheet. As in, we have already discussed in the previous question, this is to a power of central government, and in 1992 they changed the financial year from December 31st to March 31st. So answer is central government. So this is our answer. So here we have discussed total 15 questions, and till now in 6 lectures we discussed 100 questions, and all these questions basically theory is mentioned in video lectures or discussed in video lectures and in our notes also. And if you watch these only MCQ series videos, I can give guarantee you can score more than 60 marks in your exam. And if you revise our notes also, then our target is to be increased 70 plus, which is must for you to clear the exam, because when you clear the exam you get one increment, which is very helpful for you also. So students, in the next lecture we discuss 20 questions, not 15, 20 questions in the next lecture we have to discuss, basically from the chapter 4. So you have to revise the chapter 4 from the notes also before watching the video. So thank you.